The Treasury Department says the U.S. is getting closer to the day it may no longer be able to pay all of its bills, that day, October 17th. Now, besides the very real prospect of interest rates rocketing and stocks most likely crashing, the government's going to have some very tough choices to make. First of all, what is the debt ceiling? It's the legal amount the U.S. government can borrow to pay its bills. That's the debt ceiling. But why is America borrowing? Well, because the government spends more every month than it brings in. It is financing America's operations, the way you might finance your house if you didn't have the cash to buy it outright, but you had good credit or income, or the way you finance a car, or the way you finance a small business. Now, if Congress doesn't raise the debt ceiling, Congress won't have the money it needs to pay the bills coming due. Here's how it works. Consider this pile of cash here. This is funny money, but consider this pile of cash. There's nothing funny about the choices the Treasury is going to have to make if we don't raise the debt ceiling on October 17th. So let's play the pay game. Who gets paid? After October 17th, in the month after we hit that magic mark, what's coming due? Well, there's interest on our treasuries, interest on our debt, $35 billion. Let's assume you want to pay that. You want to make sure that America makes good on its promises and pays its creditors, $35 billion. Let's say you also want to make sure you're paying for Medicare and Medicaid. That's $69 billion out the door there. Now, let's also say you want to make sure that seniors get their checks. $49 billion is what seniors will have due in the month. And military pay, don't forget about the military. Pay and retirement benefits, that's $10 billion. Now, we also have things like education. That's $12 billion just in the month after October 17th. There's also defense vendors, $28 billion there, and food stamps. And don't forget unemployment benefits. That's going to be another $20 billion. Okay, add that all up, $220 billion, a little more than that. Remember, Treasury Secretary says there's $30 billion in the bank on October 17th, but $220 billion is what we just said are the priorities to pay. But wait, if you pay for those, you might have to consider these other expenses. How about IRS tax refunds? $4 billion there. Veterans benefits? $4 billion there. Federal salaries? That's $24 billion. Their benefits. Also, Health and Human Services grants, like for things like social or scientific research and health training in rural areas. That's $7 billion. Their supplemental security income? That's $3 billion. And then look at this, $64 billion. That's other spending. That's FEMA, roads, air traffic control. Altogether, those priorities would cost $106 billion, but you have already put all of this out the door. You've already paid this for your priorities, but you have another $106 billion waiting to be. That's not even everything that's due. That's the kind of game the Treasury Department may be forced to play if Congress lets it get to that point and real people and programs are caught in the balance. This math just doesn't work. Christine Romans, CNN, New York.